Partial funding for this season of the Denver Loft Sessions is provided by Venture Technologies, your local technology solutions provider. Visit them online at ventech.com.
We're facing west on Denver Loft Sessions right here, right now. That's what they see. Brand new shiny cars and boys on her arm. What else could she really need? But she knows the world is bigger than it seems. And she wakes up every morning reminded of what she's supposed to be. Somehow she's got a rep to keep. So instead of falling to her knees, she'll look you in the eye and act like nothing's wrong. The perfect life in what it seems. Now she wakes up every morning reminded of what she's supposed to be. Barbie doll, a princess growing up to be a queen. Maybe life ain't everything she thought it would be. Said she could be anything, anything but free. Dreaming of what she could be, what she could become. Making love anything she wants it to be. Now she could do anything, she's absolutely free. Absolutely free.
I'm Jamie Crowbartley, and I'm from Boulder, Colorado, and I'm the drummer.
My name's Jace Hill. I'm from Denver, Colorado, and I play guitar.
My name is Josh Emmons. I'm from Castle Rock, Colorado, and I play the bass.
Hi, I'm Sydney. I play guitar and I sing, and we're from Jacksonville, Florida.
And I'm Caitlin, and I also play guitar and sing, and we live in Denver now.
I was almost born on an airplane coming home from the recording of my dad's first album.
Well, I picked up tuba in the third grade, so that would have to be the first playing experience.
You are my sunshine, my only sunshine. That was the very first experience, singing that in first grade.
The first time I performed, I was 9 years old, and I performed in a music hall, and I played my little pink guitar. It was a Luna and had a fairy on it, and I played Bubbly by Colby Calais with my guitar teacher. Well, my mom's family is very musical. No one ever was professional, but you know, we go to Thanksgivings together, and you know, you bring out the guitar and sing. We're a big Southern family, so that's always an aspect of how our family always worked. And we always loved the aspect of music and always wanted to learn how to harmonize with each other. And so that's kind of where it started, and it just continued to grow, and we fell in love with it. Our song, Keep Walking, it's been a crazy ride, but I mean, it's a beautiful adventure. And so it's kind of about how even when you don't know what to do, you just got to keep walking because it's a beautiful road and continue.
You know, Dory said keep swimming, but since we're in Denver, there's less water than there is in Finding Nemo. So we called it keep walking because we can't swim as much.
Twists and it spins and it takes you by surprise. We can't always see the end, but we won't let it keep us from where we began. We gotta keep moving. Here we go, down another road. I'm letting go, I'm losing control. I know all enough where I'm supposed to. Die. It pushes and pulls and it changes its mind. Nothing's ever set in stone, but we won't let it keep us from where we will go. We gotta keep moving. Here we go. The world is ours if we want it. We gotta take a chance. We'll get knocked down, it won't stop us. We'll find a way to stand. The world is ours if we want it. We gotta take a chance. We'll get knocked down.
I love country music, I love alternative, I love singer-songwriter. There's not a genre that I haven't listened to. I love metal music. I do, it's in my soul. My dad always, the first album I remember listening to was the Metallica album On a Ride to Florida for Thanksgiving. My dad said, this is totally necessary for your growth.
Yeah.
When you're at Red Rocks for a hike or a concert, did you know you can do your part to keep one of Denver's favorite parks clean? Friends of Red Rocks is a large volunteer organization that cleans up the park monthly and during shows. They do their cleanup thing on the last Saturday of each month and meet in the South Lot. Go online for more info. And remember, when you're at the Rocks this year, partying at Shakedown Street in the South Lot, or tossing a football and bumping the bass in the North, please pick up after yourself. If you enjoy the arts, which are a big part of civic life, then stay informed on other civic things by watching award-winning local TV programs and city council meetings live and on demand every day on Denver 8 TV. Is your main mode of transportation around town two wheels rather than four? City Council and the mayor have made bicycling and pedestrian infrastructure a large budget priority for 2014. The mayor's Bicycle Advisory Committee meets every month, and you can have your say about biking issues in our city at these meetings. Wheel on over to denvergov.org for more information.
My dad had a guitar laying around, and he'd play it in his underwear. Around the house, he'd just sit there and sing little Eagles tunes and stuff, and then I got curious. I got real curious.
Oh, definitely getting better. There's been some lulls in the last couple years, but it seems like that there's more of a industry type of vibe in Denver now. That that whole groovy Boulder family type of thing is more molding into a corporate sense, I should say, which is good. But people like Chuck Morris helping bands out like The Fray and the Lumineers and whatnot. You know, there's definitely some strong influence of the industry with guys like that.
It's very strong. There's a lot of attention coming towards it. I come from basically kind of the rock and roll metal scene and stuff, and there was for years it was really, really stale and kind of, you know, there wasn't really anybody coming out. But I broadened my horizons and I've seen all the different genres, and there's a lot of really good players and bands coming out.
It's a very strange scene. There's a lot going on. I've seen really no predominant, you know, musical genre takeover. It's really kind of chaotic in a lot of ways. It's growing, I will say that. I mean, there's a lot of different musicians here doing a lot of different amazing things. It's really picking up.
I think it's amazing. There's so many different things going on. There's always a band in town or a band playing like every night. So no matter what, like I want to go hear a band, I can find one. And there's so much variety. My mood can change and there's a band playing fully to fill my need.
I mean, they've been so welcoming to us. I love all the different genres and all the different places you can go see the music, and I just love the Denver music thing. I think it's awesome.
So the song Flowers was written about a friend of mine, and we've been friends since forever. And I don't know, for a while I felt like she was losing herself and everyone else, and I just wanted my friend back. Like, I saw her trying to be what everybody else wanted to see her as. And you know what? I saw her start coming back to being her, and the song just, it hits me every time, because as much as she went through that, I went through it at the same time. Just losing myself in that world of everybody else. And it's a real fight sometimes to stay true to you, but I think it's really worth it.
Where did she go? That girl I used to know.
Yes, tremendously. I've seen them punch each other, actually. They punched me on numerous occasions, and that was upsetting, generally. See, they're going off in the background right there. I'm about to... It was bad.
Oh, we love each other, most of the
time. It has gotten significantly better from when we were little.
When we were younger, there was definitely a lot more issues, and music is bringing us together.
Yes, it is.
We still both have, you know, we're mildly type A, so we argue.
Occasion. So, but we get through it because we love each other.
So you can go and try to leave, but no one's following. Your mama ain't here no more. Welcome to the real world.
If you enjoy the arts, which are a big part of civic life, then stay informed on other civic things by watching award-winning local TV programs and city council meetings live and on demand every day on Denver 8 TV. Denver music fans know how lucky we are to have the world-class concert venue Red Rocks right in our backyard. This season's concert schedule is filling up fast, so check online for when your favorite artists will be playing. Many of the same production pros that bring you the Denver Loft Sessions also produce another great show on Denver 8 TV, Red Rocks Premieres. Go online for more information and schedules for both shows. Be sure to check us out on Facebook and YouTube. So whether you're enjoying your favorite music outside at the Rocks or on your couch with Denver ATV, we'll keep you rocking all year long.
Our parents are incredibly supportive. I cannot believe, like, I wouldn't be able to do any of this without them. At first, my dad was sold on me being a pharmacist, but I don't like math all that much. So it took me a little while, but once he saw how much I loved it and how much we loved it as a group, he was completely behind us. And we just feel really blessed to have parents who are willing to invest in our dreams and drive us around and take us to crazy places. Like, we're just blessed to have him.
When he was younger, he loved skateboarding, and he still does. As you can see, he hurt his leg skateboarding. But so his dad helped him build a 9-foot half pipe in his backyard so he could skateboard all the time. So he's done that for us with all of this. He supported us, and my mom is incredible. She fixes my hair all of the time.
And she's actually the one who started teaching us how to sing to begin with. She won't sing in front of anybody, but she would come and sit in our rooms with us when we were like 5 and 6 and teach us how to sing the vibrato and help us figure out how to harmonize. So she is incredibly inspirational. She's incredible.
Brad Pitt.
Orlando Bloom.
Undoubtedly Gary Busey.
I would have to go with Anna Kendrick. She's probably my favorite.
No doubt Jennifer Lawrence.
I think the band is probably the most important thing I've done musically so far, and it's really been my favorite thing I've done.
I didn't know coming into it that I was going to be sitting with these virtuosic teenagers, you know, and their songwriting is beyond their years. They're phenomenal.
Your way, but you can't fool me with your little charade. Go ahead, never bother keeping a foot on the ground. You're in the big leagues now. Maybe you should get back to your playground. You think you have the perfect dance. You bet everyone gonna follow your plan. Things ain't how you want them to be. You're not the king of anything. You can call your wife, but no one's coming. So you can try to be the king, but I swear no one's listening. You can call your wife, but no one's coming. So you can go and try to leave, but no one's following. Your mama ain't here no more. Welcome to the real world.
Fox Street boasts a big, soulful rock and roll sound laced with three-part harmonies, screaming guitars, soulful sax, and a funky rhythm section. They're one of the hardest-working rock and roll bands on the Colorado music scene, and they're coming to the next Denver Loft Sessions. Partial funding for this season of the Denver Loft Sessions is provided by Venture Technologies, your local technology solutions provider. Visit them online at ventech.com.